Sì, ho fatto una mollina. And that is it. Nice and easy, nice and slow.
How are you doing? Brian King, UK 4 TV. Today we're over in Burnley. We're at Nicola Edwards Carpetagian, and we're joined by Nicola herself, the owner. All right, Nicola, how are you doing?
Hi, Brian. Good, thank you.
Nicola, you've got a lovely studio here. How long have you had it?
Thank you. We've been in the studio about a year and a half now.
You were the first one actually in the building, weren't
we
you?
We were, yeah.
Was it converted from a mill into like studios and offices?
Yeah. Recently converted, a lot of money spent on this place. It looks really good, you've got to admit, it looks really good.
It does,
that's
yeah.
What we was going for. Excuse me. When I was looking for premises, I wanted somewhere high end where I could bring customers, interior designers. It just fits the bill.
So
I love it here.
You're not working out of a unit or a garage or something like that?
No.
Do you work alone here or do you employ staff?
No, we have two machinists, one whipper, and my husband has recently joined the business as well.
Right, and do you get on with your husband at work?
Yes, it's all good.
That's always a bonus. Yeah. What services do you offer, Nicola?
We offer all aspects of carpet edging, so we specialise in the tape binding. The wide bordered tape, we offer whipping, and we also do the speed binding as well.
Right, so basically you cover everything involved with carpet edging?
Yeah, more or less. Not rugs though, we do not do rugs.
Right.
Anymore.
There's been a massive increase in stair runners over the last year or so. I know I'm doing it a lot more than I have previously. Have you noticed an increase in the volume of your work?
Yes, absolutely. There's a lot more interest, we're always getting new inquiries. There's a lot of people coming through of end users interested, not sure how it works. What we always do, so we do get a lot of interest on Instagram, and what I always do is divert them to the nearest carpet retailer in their area. So we have retail partners, that's how it works. I never deal with the public, it's always a retail partner. If somebody gets in touch with me from, I don't know, Birmingham, I'll send them to our local retail partner in that area.
So you actually work with retailers?
Oh yeah,
well?
Yeah.
Oh, that's,
yeah, it yeah. is a good little thing. I don't do to the public.
Do you have a favourite thing you like to work with? Like, do you prefer whipping? Do you prefer binding, speed edging?
Binding, always the binding. That's what I specialise in.
But the binding is harder than the others? Is it
yeah,
the challenge
yeah.
you like?
It is, yeah. It's definitely more challenging, but it's more rewarding as well to see them. I absolutely love them, everyone that I do. They're all my babies.
Nicola, you're widely recognised literally throughout the country for your stitching, how consistent it is.
Thank you.
How did you get it so good?
Practice, standards and skill.
Well, that makes sense to be
yeah.
honest.
Yeah.
What materials do you use? Is the different qualities in cotton binding and the stitching you use? Like carpet, you get a cheaper carpet.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we only use the highest quality cotton edging. I don't know if you can see that there. When I first started out, I tested out loads of different suppliers, different materials. I whittled it down. These are the best quality of them. That's all we use.
And what sewing machines do you use? Is it same again? Is there different qualities in machines?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when I started out, I did a lot of research into which machines we should buy. I looked at what other people were using. I whittled it down to an industrial jack machine. I'm not sure what model it is. It's just perfect for what I need. It's never let me down.
And is the jack machine for one specific thing? Or does
taping.
It do?
We just do the taping on the jack machines.
Well, what about, say, the speed binding? Is that a separate machine?
That is a separate machine. That's the old girl.
Right. And what about your whipping? Do you use?
Whipping Carpet Kings. We've got a Carpet Kings whipping machine. Very highly recommended, Carpet Kings as a company.
I think they're the most popular one.
They are. Yeah, and Joe as well. We love Joe.
What carpets do you prefer to work with, Nicola? Is there easier carpets to work with than others?
Yes, some are easier than others. I prefer 100% flat weave herringbone. They just look the part, they perform. They look stylish, they're easier to work with, but they just look so good, it's so classy.
What about sisal?
Love it, love a bit of sisal.
What do you prefer, say, like flat weaving sisal over, say, a twist pattern?
Absolutely, yes, I don't like thick carpets, my followers will know, we do not like thick carpets in this place.
Why is that?
Oh, no, they just look messy. It's just taste, I guess, but it's not for me.
Right.
I'll do it, but I don't like it.
Oh, did you get into bespoke binding?
How did I get into it? I wanted a rug making a few years ago when I worked as a sales rep, and I couldn't really find anybody that did it at a reasonable price. The only people that I could find that did it was Alternative or Crucial Trading. They were all so expensive because you had to buy their carpets. And I thought, right, there could be a little gap here to offer a service where you can buy a cheaper carpet and have it edged.
And the rest is history.
Yeah, and here we are today.
There seems to be a bit of a craze at the minute in taking up binding. Mm-hmm. I've noticed on social media there's a few people starting buying machines and offering the service.
Yes.
What advice would you give to somebody starting up, Nicola?
Oh, what advice would I give? None.
Right, that's fair enough. What binding job are you most proud of? Do you have one, like, what springs to mind, or a certain person you've done?
No, I really, really don't have any favourite ones. I love them all, they're all my babies. I love when I see them in the place, in the homes. I love it. We've done quite a few Premiership footballers. My first ever one, I can tell you my first ever famous one. Where is it? Mr. Warburton, the bread man.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. I was so proud of that. Yeah.
And have you had any disasters?
Oh yes, don't we all? Right at the beginning. Not really anymore, but at the beginning, of course. Yeah.
What's something happy. You don't want to talk about?
Mm-mm, no. Yeah. Gone, forgot about.
Nicola, what's your history in the flooring industry? How did you get into it? And you've been in it before, I take it, before?
Yes, I have. I worked for a German carpet manufacturer, Vorwerk. Do you know Vorwerk?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Very high-end, top-quality carpet. So I worked as the UK office manager for Vorwerk, and I dealt with carpet retailers across the country. I worked there for a number of years. Loved the company, loved the product, loved working with the retailers. After building relationships with them, a lot of them said, you should get out on the road, you should become a sales rep. And that's how I did it. I actually got put forward for a job for Headlam. I got the job there. And I worked on the road for a few years as a business development manager.
And then straight from there to the
US. So I was visiting carpet retailers. I covered the north of the UK. So from here, Lancashire, all the way up to the Scottish border. That was my patch.
So quite a big patch.
Yeah, so I had a really big patch. I was well known in the industry before I started this up.
Right.
I already had a customer base really before I started.
Nicola, do you offer a postage service, or is it just the case of your customer drops off and picks up?
We do both. Local customers pick up and drop off. We also offer a collection and delivery service. Carpet retailers love this. It's a very simple, easy service for them. So they need to bag the carpet up, ready to go. I will then email over a label. They stick it on. DHL come in, pick up, and that's it.
So you actually offer a pickup service,
yeah,
as well?
Yeah, we do collection and delivery.
Well, that's easy for the retailer.
Very easy.
With the expense of binding tape, mm-hmm. do you stock a lot of tape, or do you just buy it for each individual job?
We tend to stock the common colours, so blacks, greys, a few beiges. We do keep stock of them. Different coloured, like wild colours, we order them in.
Is there a particular colour what's most popular, or is it just
black? Classic black, always. Stair and edge.
Do you have to cut down the carpet?
No. Nope. No, we don't do that.
So your customers got to cut it down.
They do. They know that. They get in trouble when they don't do that.
Fair enough. Last one, Nicola. Do you have any plans for the future? Anything you're expanding into? Or any plans?
Well, I think the next plan would be to have a display stand made, maybe some steps with our stair runners on that carpet retailers can have in their shops to help sell the product.
So you can actually look at it on the actual product and get the little samples out.
Yeah, we just have this at the minute. We just have the sample swatches. But I think that would work. I think a nice little display stand that we could sell into the retailers.
Yeah, great. Like you see in shops in the display.
Yeah, of course. Why not?
Anyway, Nicola, thanks very much for inviting me.
Come on, come say hello. I'm on time,
all right.
Yeah. Right, anyway, Nicola, thanks very much.
He's gone red.
Thanks for having us down, and look for the future. Cheers.
Thank you.